In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, one God, amen. Good morning, everyone. Good to see everybody on this beautiful, beautiful, lovely weekend. And we are still in the Apostles' Fast. And since the time of the Ascension, when Christ rose, right, that was the last action, the church focuses until the Feast of Nowruz on September 11th or 12th, we focus on the person of the Holy Trinity, of the Holy Spirit. We saw that in the first week when he said, if, you know, when you pray, ask for the Holy Spirit. And we're seeing it today when he talked about blasphemy, the blasphemy of the Holy Spirit. And that is the unforgivable sin. So we need to be careful that we don't do this. But we want to focus on another part. But before that, do you ever have a situation when just somebody is talking and talking and talking and talking and you're like, all right, keep it going. Keep it going. Or somebody just like thinks he's got, like he reinvented sliced bread. He reinvented sliced bread. Like he comes and tells you, like he's going to tell you the most impactful thing. You know, I figured out how to lose weight. And you're like, man, I've been trying to do this for like 20 years. Tell me, you got to eat less and you got to exercise more. Really? All right, never heard that before, right? Or somebody, I figured out how to make millions of dollars. Everybody's ears are open. What is it? Buy low, sell high. Really? Never heard that before. Or some people just speak, and frankly, whatever they're saying, you just don't care. Like, move on. Today, at least personally, I feel like I always want to run away from this passage. I never want to read this passage. But of course, the church puts us in this in our lectionary year round. So arguably, this is the hardest. Next week, we're going to read even harder commandments like love your enemies and, you know, take up your cross. We have hard commandments and hard sayings. This is arguably one of the hardest. This is what Christ said today. So these are the words from Christ. I say to you that for every idle word men may speak, they will give account of it on the day of judgment. For by your words you will be justified, and by your words you will be condemned. So the blah, blah, blahs out there, the ones that kind of like talk and you're just like, hurry up, or have these nuggets of information, or just things that you don't, maybe this one is for us here. Because this one is a killer. Did we understand the depth of this verse? Every, not bad word, not every time we swear or curse or get angry. Every idle word, we're going to be asked about it. As we saw in Corinthians, when we read the Pauline epistle, that he's going to stand there as a judge. And as we read in 1 Peter in the about the time of Noah and Lot, how there was a judgment. There's going to be a judgment. We're going to be standing. I know none of us like to imagine this, right? But we should. Our fathers tell us, remember our death every day. We need to be standing. We will be standing. All right? This will happen. Either we're going to be ready or not ready. That's up to us. But this is our scene, me and God. Me and God. And every idle word. Why did you speak this? Why did you say this at that party? Why did you do that? Every idle word, I'm going to have to come up for a reason. As she said, because by your words, you're going to be justified, and by your words, you'll be condemned. So if we haven't opened our apps already, open up your apps so we can follow along and give this, because unless you don't give idle words, then maybe don't open your app. But if we want to remember and keep this for yourself, we want to know what this is, because we will be accountable for this. So what's an idle word? It was, in terms of, like, if you look at the root meaning in Greek, it's the same kind of meaning about, remember that parable when Jesus hired a whole bunch of laborers, one at the first hour and the third hour, the sixth hour, the ninth and the 11th hour. And he said, like, you guys are standing here idle. Like, in other words, you're standing here inactive. Like, go work. I'll pay you something. That's what idle means, inactive. It's unfruitful. It's useless or unprofitable. Those are idle words. Other versions of the Bible, instead of the word idle, they say empty or worthless or exaggerated. How many of us exaggerate when we speak? These are idle words, empty, worthless, or exaggerated. And we will be held accountable. We will be held accountable. Let's look at our fathers, St. Jerome and St. Basil the Great, said the following. So remember like that scene that we never want to think about, right? They thought about it. That's why they're called saints. On the day of judgment, each person must render an account of his or her words. An idle word is what is spoken without benefit to the speaker and to the listener. St. Basil says almost the same thing. He says, one should not say idle words from which there is no benefit whatsoever for saying or doing even something good that is not constructive for the faith means offending the Holy Spirit of God, which is, again, remember our theme in this section all the way up to Nauru's September 11th. So we offend the Holy Spirit of God because we are given the Spirit of God. We're given the Spirit of God. So that means everything coming out of us should be beneficial, spiritual, fruitful, not empty and useless and worthless. So that's how it's related to the theme of this time. Every word is going to be given account. Why? Like, what's the big deal? Like, I get it if I swear, and I mean, even the world gets it, right? I get it if I, like, say something really bad. I get it if I criticize or make something, but why idle? Idle words can kill. Idle words can kill. Death and life are in the power of the tongue. And we're going to focus on that one next week. So we're doing like two parts on the words, but it's related to next week's gospel as well. So we'll hold off on that one till next week. Idle words bring disrespect. This is like, this is a verse we all need to know. This is like truly a golden nugget from King Solomon in Proverbs. Even a fool, so he's calling it, like even a fool who keeps silent is considered wise. A fool who decides to do one thing, keep silent, makes him wise. When he closes his lips, he is deemed intelligent. Isn't that powerful? Like the idiot around us, the one that always maybe like doesn't know anything, if he or she keeps silent, he's considered wise. A fool can go to a wise person by staying silent. Right? Brings disrespect. Maybe I'm gossiping. So a fool will decide not to gossip and just keep that and be silent. Wise. A fool grumbles, complains. Oh, it's too cold in Chicago. Oh, I can't bear this heat. Just grumbles. Everything's complaining. I don't like the Dems. I don't like the Republicans. I don't like this. Grumbles. Just be quiet. Be quiet. Idle words, ouch, open the gates of hell. In St. James, the tongue is fire, a world of iniquity. The tongue is so set among our members that it defiles the whole body and sets on fire the course of nature, and it is set on fire by hell. It's powerful stuff. Didn't I tell you? It stabs me. I run away from this passage if I had a choice, but it's there, and we have to read it. And every word is inspired, and every word is for my salvation. So how? How do I go from blah, 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 and not have idle words as my life? Number one, be a better listener. This is hugely lacking in our society, in our skills. Think about it. At school, we took reading, we took writing, we took, but anybody take a listening 101 out there? Anybody? How much we lack listening. Be a good listener. And this is all scriptural, so many verses, right? But the easy one from St. James, be swift to hear. The rest of it is slow to speak, slow to wrath, right? But be swift to hear. Let's focus on that. He's telling you, be quick. Be good to hear. St. Paul says in Hebrews, therefore we must pay closer attention to what we have heard. Not only, St. Paul was of course focusing on the word of God, hearing the word of God, but how many of us lack, like, you know, like there's a conversation and somebody told us something and then we say it and it said like, I said it, I told you that. It's because we're not listening. We tuned out. Let us be better listeners. Let us be focused on listening. Focus on really understanding what our whoever is speaking is saying. Be a better listener. And that way my words will be much less. Because instead of caring so much on how to respond and what I'm going to say next and how I'm going to outdo whatever this person said, I'm actually going to care. Remember that third slide? I don't care what that person said. No, I'm going to care. I want to care what that person is saying. I want to care because he's probably saying something very deep. Be a better listener. Number two, reduce your words. Just reduce your words. Right? I mean, it makes sense. Every idle word that we speak will be accountable. So if I say less words, there's less chances to mess up because we'll mess up a lot. And that's what, again, Proverbs. In the multitude of words, sin is not lacking, but he who restrains his lips is wise. Almost like that other proverb, right? Somehow in COVID, Naveen got me into these food shows. Just now, like, I'm addicted to all these competition food shows, right? One of the things is you're always judged. Just like the judgment, you're judged on only what you give. So if you have three items, a protein, a starch, and a vegetable, right? You're going to be judged on everything. But let's say one of them stinks. You're going to be judged. And they'll say, why'd you put that on the plate? Did you taste it? Is this good? No, it's not good. Why'd you put on? Now I have to judge you. Less sometimes is more. Don't put it on the plate if it's no good. Don't get it out of your mouth if it's no good. Once, the great Abba Makarios, St. Makarios the Great, he dismissed the assembly of the monks with one word, flee. That's what he said. He just said flee. And he said flee? They also flee from what? And he said, flee from this. And he put his finger on his lips. And he said, flee from that. We've heard the saying, right? In terms of, in the multitude of the words, there is sin. It has been said that it's better to be thought of a fool as one you open your mouth and then you remove all doubt. Right? The last thing for our idle words is everything is coming from the heart. That's what we read at the end. A good man out of the good treasure of his heart brings forth good things. Remember? Focus is the Holy Spirit. And that's why when we say idle words, it's an attack on the Holy Spirit inside us. Because if we have the Holy Spirit inside us, we're not blaspheming against the Holy Spirit, but listening and being in tune with the Holy Spirit, out of the heart brings forth good things. Like St. Paul says, walk in the Spirit, and you should not fulfill the lust of the flesh. And that's why in the first Sunday, when Father AP was with us, we read that whole Our Father passage, but at the end, you need to ask for the Holy Spirit. Ask for the Holy Spirit. Saint Ignatius said, from the fruit, the tree is known, saying, he who speaks of faith is known by his deeds. It is not enough that we declare our faith, but we have to manifest it practically to the very end. Out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. This is the season, and that's why it's such an important fast. Every fast is different, by the way, right? This one, Wednesday and Friday, are the original fast. There was no such thing as Easter. There was no such thing as Nativity. Like when the church fasted, they fasted Wednesday and Friday and this fast. This is the important ones because it's the one that we want to, as we started on Pentecost, to create in me a clean heart, to renew a right spirit within me, to have like a clean heart so that I can preach, I can serve, I can do good things and not have idle words. Of course, in a half an hour, we're all going to be downstairs having coffee, right? I don't want total silence. Don't take this as, man, we better not speak. And everybody's sitting in their own corner and drinking their coffee and eating their bagel and nobody's talking. No, everybody's afraid of it. No, right? Again, going back to King Solomon, there's a time to keep silent and a time to speak, all right? Coffee hour is a time to speak, but let's watch our babbling at all times. And glory be to God forever. Amen.